رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي.
The Ottomans, may Allah bless them and reward them for their amazing work. Many of us sitting in this room wouldn't be Muslim today were it not for the Ottoman Empire. This empire was the ones who carried the flag of Islam for centuries. We may not know much about them. Many Arabs, unfortunately, might have been misinformed about them because of the nationalism that they had been taught in school. They would say, "You are an Arab, you are mighty, and you're better than these Turks." This is what many people are taught in their schools. Up until today, in Egypt, this is what they were all taught. They were never taught a single thing about the Ottomans, how they were the heroes of Islam, how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned one of their leaders and praised him in a hadith. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who did he praise from our day? Who did he specifically mention? Yet one of the great leaders of the Ottoman Empire was mentioned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And who was this great man? It was Muhammad al-Fatih, Muhammad the Conqueror, as he was known. Why was he known as the Conqueror? Because he conquered the city of Istanbul, which even the historians of the Kufar will always say that this was one of the most decisive battles in the history of mankind. Usually they'll say one of their own battles, for example, the Battle of Hastings that took place in England, or another battle. But they'll always put number two. The most decisive battle in history was when the Muslims conquered Constantinople, which became the capital of the Ummah for how many centuries? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him, told us, "La taftahun al Constantiniyah, wa la ni'mu amiru amiruha, wa la ni'mu jaysh dhalika al jaysh." He said, "Verily, you will conquer Constantinople." He was speaking to his Sahaba when they were in the desert, very small in number. Can you imagine he's saying to them, "You will conquer Constantinople"? This was the greatest city on the face of the earth, the most powerful city on the face of the earth. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling them, "You," meaning the Muslims, "will conquer Constantinople." And sadaqa Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of course, this came to pass. And he said, "Blessed will be its leader. Blessed will be its leader." The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't say this about many people, but he said, "The leader who takes the city of Constantinople will be blessed, and blessed will be his army." This is Muhammad al-Fatih rahimahullah. This is a man who is sincere, who led one of the greatest empires of Islamic history. This is a man who from a very young age studied the fiqh of Islam. He spoke seven languages. He spent his whole life preparing just to conquer Constantinople. And you would see that his people, they were so prepared for this as well. They were a people who loved Islam and loved jihad. They brought Islam to so many of our countries. Were it not for the Ottomans, Bosnia would not be Muslim. Albania would not be Muslim. Almost any part of Europe would not be Muslim. So much of Central Asia, Islam was brought through the Ottomans, may Allah reward them. And you would see that this people, there's a reason why Allah blessed them, because they had this amazing intention that their lives were for the service of Islam.